The other tool in Advanced Reports and Dashboards is, of course, the Advanced Reports. This is a powerful, extensible reporting engine that is used to compile data from its SQL database into meaningful, actionable information. This can range from simple trend and tabular reports, similar to the basic reports, all the way to network modeling or compliance reporting with the add-on modules. For now, I'm just going to cover how we create reports. I'll leave exploring the library to you. Just like the dashboards, I'll start with the plus sign at the bottom of the library. As before, my system has every add-on module enabled, so there are many report templates here designed for very specific situations. Let's put together a simple one. Say the hourly usage report. This report takes a cumulative value, like energy, and breaks it into hourly increments. Now I need to configure my report inputs. Different reports will have different inputs depending upon their actions, but most will follow this general form. At the top of the page, I can give my report title, which is just the name at the top of the report. Next, I'll select some sources. I recommend grouping the sources by group name, which is the logical naming scheme set in Management Console. This report, like most, has me select the measurements individually. Some reports have a limited selection or automatically choose measurements. I'll use real energy into the load, as that makes the most sense for this report. The reporting period differs from the dashboards in that this is not necessarily ending with the current time. I can run a report on last week, a specific calendar range, or a custom fixed date. If I do choose one of these relative dates, if I save this report, every time I rerun the report, it will run relative to the current time. This is useful if I have a report that needs to be run weekly or monthly, for example. Below, there are a number of other options available, but I'm just going to generate this report as is. First, my report tells me I have some data warnings where the engine did not log any data. Depending on the type of warnings, the report may not be useful at all. Below that, I have the trend chart as requested, followed by the table of calculated data points. Remember, real energy is normally a continuously increasing value, but this report has broken it up into hourly consumption. This is especially useful on simple meters that report energy, but not demand. If I need to make a change to my report, the Show Report Inputs link provides quick access to modify the inputs. It's quite common to come back and change the measurements because one of my devices isn't logging the data as I expect, for example. I can also turn off the data table if I don't need this information. If I'm satisfied with the report, I can download it as a PDF document, an Excel spreadsheet, or a tagged image file format. I can also save this report to run later in my library. If I want to save this as a template to be filled in with other parameters, there is the option to not save all the report parameters, though I'll usually leave all of them in. Once the report is saved, I just need to select it and generate to run it relative to the current time. This is the most basic of Advanced Reports functionality, but please explore the other report templates available to you. Standard reports will also include basic bill verification, power quality monitoring, and data exporting, among other topics. Next, we'll move on to more advanced features in the software. Until then, thank you.
Thank you.